Hello all, welcome. In this video, we will discuss the important elements of dental implants. In the screen you are looking at, I pulled in four different components that will make up a complete dental implant system. We will discuss one by one, we will discuss the main characteristics, main attributes of each element. And the video, as a backup to this video, I put in a machining video that will go through the complete machining solutions for each one of those products. You can see four different components on the screen. Let me go back into my assembly, let's move this components. So I can able to show you different components, apply. Let's go back and select the abutment on the top. Let's go back and pull it. Go back and select this one. Bring it down. As you can see, there are two different abutments. One at a straight one, the other is at an angle. But you can see the bottom part of the implant that will screw in. You can see that OD thread with the flutes that will help in making a thread form on the bone or the soft tissue. But you can see a ID thread where the top piece will screw in. So now the main part of the implant, you can see the threads. These are called the buttress threads. Buttress threads is, you know, when you think about a thread, there are two different flanks. One is the clearance flank and there's a loading flank. So the loading flank will prevent the screw from being pulled out due to the axial load. If you want a stronger force to resist the pull out on the axial load, you can use the buttress threads. Those are most of the common dental implants are made using the buttress threads. Since the length by diameter ratio is less than 4, we can either single point turning or you can use a thread whirling. The video I put in, the machining video for the dental implants, you will see we use a thread whirling to make these buttress threads. So you can able to see that the first part of the stem is a conical stem. So we go and make a conical stem and then come back in with an enamel to make the flutes. The flutes have to be sharper because those are cutting flutes. Then we can either a single point turn the buttress threads or we can use the thread whirling. In the video you'll be looking at in the second part of this series, you'll see these buttress threads are formed using a thread whirling. The thread whirling, the bar stock, the spindle which holds the bar stock, these bar stocks are made from titanium because for dental implants or any implant for the matter, it's best to use a biocompatible titanium. It's an implant grade titanium. So you can see that we can be using a thread whirling to form the buttress thread. Then for the ID threads, we'll be using a thread whirling or a single point using a stick tool, or it can be if you have a machine as a rigid tapping, and if you can able to find that tap is either a metric tap 2 millimeter or 1.5 millimeter, depend upon the size. As far as the easy part for a surgeon. For a dental surgeon to go back and identify different size of the implants, it will be color coded for the ID size based on the matrix size. Either 3.5 millimeter, 3 millimeter, it will be color coded using anodizing. So that the ID will be color coded to select the easy selection of the color coding scheme for the operating surgeon to select the right size implant. The outside, the stem will be porous coded. Either we can use a anodizing solution where it will create a porous structure so able the bone can grow into it, or we'll be using a common coating such as hydroxyapatite, biocompatible glass, ceramics, or either a titanium nitride coating. Most of the systems I go with the hydroxyapatite coating. So you can see the abutment here. The abutment, either we can, since you can see able to see that both it has both the milling and turning features, it's good to use a screw machine type for this product. It's all made from a bar stock. Single bar stock can make all those things. So let's try to set up a machining setup to see how all those different components are made from a bar stock, which is a cylindrical round bar. I like to keep all these videos within a 7-minute video. So we will cover each one of them, how the design elements, how to design a dental implant, then how to machine them, how to set up a machining layout on the Siemens. How to set up the tool layout. We will create each tool, then how apply the tool path for each feature. Then from that point on, we can able to post process and able to select the based on the machine type. You will be able to post it for the control. Then you will able to simulate using the simulate machine, or we can use a VeriCAD to simulate it. Thank you for watching. In the next video, we will look at how to design and apply the tool path for these dental implants. Thank you.